Hey, good morning, Facebook friends. Another vertical hope today for you from Faith Builders Ministries, found in Acts 3, 1 through 8. You can read it, but let me just paraphrase it for now. There was a crippled man sitting at the gate of Beautiful, and he came every day. Every single day, one of his friends brought him to this gate to set him there to beg for alms. And when he was sitting there, Peter and John saw them, and he asked them for money. Peter looked straight at him and said, and did John. Then Peter said, look at us. So he told the crippled man, listen, look at us. So the man gave him his attention, expecting to get something from them. Then Peter said, silver and gold I have none, but what I have I give to you. In the name of Jesus of Nazareth, walk. Taking him by the right hand, he helped him up, and instantly this man's feet and ankles became strong. He jumped to his feet and began to walk. Then he went to them, to the temple courts, walking and jumping and praising God. Now listen, I want to point out a few things. Number one, this man, his friends took him every day to the temple gate. And I'm wondering, what in the world? Every day they took him there. And every day, it doesn't say in the word that they prayed for him. They just dropped him off there. And this is what I recognize in the scripture. He went every day. He didn't get to skip a day. He went every day. And you know what? He was in it for just enough. That's what he was in it for. He went every day, stuck out his alm bucket, and let people walk by him and sow into his lameness, sow into his distress, his sickness, his crippledness, his heartache, his dysfunction, his hopelessness. Every day, people dropped a penny or bucket, some money in the bucket for him. Every single day. But what stuck out at me the most is that he went there every day. He was in it for just enough for the day. The word of God didn't say he got to skip a day. No, it said he went there every day expecting just enough. And that's where I want to point to you today. How many of you out there are in it for just enough for today? Oh Lord, just bless me for this. Just, oh Lord, do this for me today. Just, oh Lord, you know, help me pay my electric bill. Oh Lord, help me make my car payment. Oh Lord, help me have the money to buy the groceries. Oh Lord, but you know what? You're just praying for just enough to get by on. Just enough to get by on. But I'm going to say to you today, this is a bold saying, but I'm going to say to you, that's pure selfishness. Pray for more than enough. Pray that they got not a God that would only pay your electric bill, but give you more left over. Increase your pay. Increase your wages. Increase your paycheck. Because you want to have more than enough. Because you don't want to just sit around and make sure your needs are met. But don't you care about somebody else's needs being met? Don't you want to be a blessing instead of always be the receiving end of the blessing? I mean, I don't want to sit around and just go, oh Lord, just please pray over this ministry so, you know, I can reach 10 people. No, I want to pray that, Lord, just, I'm going to ask you to bless this ministry because I want to reach 10 million people. I don't want to pray small prayers. I don't want to believe small. I don't want to stick my elms bucket out just saying, here, just let me get enough for today but not enough to skip a day. I don't want to be crippled in my thinking. I don't want to be crippled in my blessings. I don't want to be crippled anywhere in my body. I don't want to be crippled in my mind. I don't want to be crippled in my spirit. I want to go out there and be a blessing to others. So we need to up our game here. We need to up our prayers now. Remember me talking about, you know, isolating that faith muscle? Come on now. Let's get some power behind those prayers. Let's start believing for more than enough. Let's not just say, let me get enough to get by on today, but let me have enough to be a blessing to others. I don't just go to church anymore to receive, but I go to church to be a blessing. And if I miss church, I think this, well, who missed out on the whatever God wanted me to sow into that person today? It's not about us. You know, it's a very small portion, if any, about us. It's about others. It's about reaching others. It's no testimony, really. If you just sat around and you're always just getting the blessings, if you're never being blessed, if you're never going to be a blessing to others, you know what? We are being blessed to be a blessing. So let's start praying those outrageous prayers. Let's start praying faith down from heaven. Let's start standing on the word of God more. Let's not just stick out our elms bucket and say, I'm just here for just enough for today. Let's just take our elms bucket back and say, Lord Jesus, I'm believing you for the multitude. I believe in you to multiply. I'm believing for you not only to bless my needs, but bless me so I can bless somebody else's needs. Amen. I'll tell you what, I get so excited about the word of God and sharing it with you guys that I could just go and go like a firecracker. All right, y'all be blessed. The vertical hope for you today is that, listen, if you are using your mouth to pray for your needs, you can also use it to help, to ask God to help you meet somebody else's needs. Amen. Amen. Bye-bye.